Cienfuegos is known as the Pearl of the South, thanks to its beautiful bay. But if you ask me, it should also be known as the City of Pillars, because I have never been to a city with so many pillars. But that is only one of the reasons why you should visit this friend's city in Cuba. Welcome to Maria's travel tips. Cienfuegos lies 230 kilometers from Havana, and if you don't know how to get there, I suggest that you watch my video, How to Travel in Cuba. Tip number one, walk on the famous boulevard Paseo El Prado, with all the pillars, which is beautiful in day and night time. On the boulevard there's also Wi-Fi, so if you brought the Wi-Fi card, you can get access here. And if you don't know what card I'm talking about, you should watch my other video before going to Cuba, where I'll give you my best tips to what you should know, from power outlet to how to get Wi-Fi, which is not everywhere and you have to pay for it. Tip number two, other great boulevards and buildings you should see. Another boulevard you should see is the Boulevard San Fernando, which is like a small Champs-Élysées with shops and restaurants. The boulevard will lead you directly to the famous central plaza, Parque José Martí. You should see this park for several reasons. First of all, it's a really nice place to just relax, but the park also has Wi-Fi. And the plaza is also surrounded with beautiful and historical buildings. For example, the cathedral, Catedral de Nuestra Señora de la Purísima Concepción. It was built in 1800th century and it is free to go inside and a great place to just cool down from the hot sun. Right in front of the Parque José Martí is the famous theatre Thomas Terry, where you can also get a tour inside for $5. And at the end of the park is the Arch of Triumph, which is the only one in Cuba. The Arch is a monument to Cuban independence. Just next to the Arch of Triumph is this blue and stunning building. I was told that it is possible to go up in the tower and see the view, and it should even be free, but when I came the stairs were closed. But no matter if the stairs are closed or not, I suggest that you go inside because there might be a free exhibition like when I was there. Walking around the Parque José Martí, you cannot avoid noticing this grey big building that is so big that you have to walk to the cathedral to get a photo of most of the building. The name of the building is Palacio de Gobierno, and it is where the provincial government works. Therefore, you're not allowed to go in, but you can still get a great look of the main hall when you're standing at the entrance. Tip number three, see the market. If you turn right after Palacio de Gobierno, you'll see a market where you can buy different types of handcraft products. The market ends at the harbor, which is also a really nice place to chill. Tip number four, how to get around in the city. Since you don't have Wi-Fi as you probably are used to in your own country, I recommend that you download the free app MapsMe. Because the app works offline, but it is tracking you so you know exactly where you are in Cienfuegos, and it makes it so much easier to go to different places in the city. The app also has good reviews over restaurants in the town. Tip number five, where to sleep. I will recommend that you book a casa particulares, which means that you'll stay at a Cuban family in a room, because then you get a more authentic experience. The Cuban houses don't look like much from the outside, but they can be really impressive inside with the huge doors, windows and furniture, so it's a great way to learn about the Cuban culture. Another reason for staying at a casa particulares is that most hostess offers breakfast and maybe even dinner for a reasonable price. I booked my casa particulares through Airbnb. And now to another question, how long time should you stay in Cienfuegos? I had two overnights in Cienfuegos and I think it was fine because I got to see most of the city because it ain't that big and I had enough time to explore its character. Tip number seven, where and what to eat. I ate at the restaurant Las Mamparas, which has really good ratings on Lonely Planet and on the app MapsMe. Anyway, I ordered chicken and the house french fries and I just love the fries. And after the meal, you might be lucky to see a beautiful sunset because the restaurant is close to the bay. Another nice place to eat was at the shopping boulevard San Fernando, where we ate at a restaurant on the first floor who also had a beautiful ceiling and made good drinks like the famous chanchanchera, which is a drink that was created in Trinidad in the 19th century but is famous all over Cuba. It consists of honey, lime, soda and rum. Another thing I'll suggest that you try is the cheap peso food like the pizza. To be honest, I don't think you need to try it more than once, but I do think that you should try it so you know what kind of food the Cubans are eating. Tip number 8 is about traveling, and it's mainly for backpackers if you're going to Trinidad or Havana and you need to get to the Viasol office in Cienfuegos. So here's a little tip to where to go in the station if your Spanish is limited like mine. Because the big entrance with the stairs is for the Cubans, so the Viasol is on the other side of the building. However, when I came, the system was broken because it could not go online. I came back later and there was still no improvement. So I ended up taking a colectivo taxi. And if you want to go to Trinidad as well, like I did, or another place, a lot of Cubans will ask you on the way to the station if you want to go with a colectivo taxi. My host also offered me to arrange a colectivo taxi for me. Even though it was $4 more expensive than the bus, you do save time because you will be picked up at your casa particulares or wherever you are staying and brought to your new address as well. Like I said, I went to Trinidad, and if you want to know more about Trinidad, you can just click on this link. I've also made videos from Havana, Vinales, and some videos about what you should know before going to Cuba and how to travel in Cuba if you're interested. You're welcome to comment below if you have any questions and I'll get back to you. Feel also free to subscribe if you want more of my travel tips. I wish you a very good day. Bye.